Welcome to
Chopped.
In today's episode, you're going to be seeing two young contestants in Sean Campbell
and Michael McGraw
battle it out to see who will be chopped. We are your hosts, Sean Campbell,
Ron Burgundy.
I'm glad you guys chose to watch this episode. It is going to be a lot of fun. These two are some of the best chefs there are in the business.
You will be rewarded for tuning in today, because Sean and Michael, for the entree round, will be making
pizza!
Surprise, motherfucker.
What?
No, you
can't.
So, dude, Sean Campbell, been chefing for a couple years now, nothing big. Other than cooking in the kitchen, I've been known as a vape god. Vape Nation, baby.
I'm Michael McGraw. I've been cooking for most of my life. My transgender mother taught me everything I know. And before she passed, I told her I would win this competition for her. Right here, I grab Prego sauce for the pizza and my crust.
So it looks as though Sean might be in the wrong aisle. What is he doing?
I believe he is taking a whippet. That is where you inhale the fumes from a whipped cream can to get a little juiced up.
Let's cut to Michael.
Alright, so here we have firecracker in Italian. We're making pizza, so we're gonna want Italian. Now we're gonna get the cheese. Right here, I went to go grab two types of cheese, mozzarella and parmesan, because my pizza will be stuffed crust.
It looks as though Michael is almost done shopping, and we don't know where Sean is right now.
That's right, Sean. We haven't seen Sean since he took the whippet. We are concerned, but cameramen are on the hunt for him.
Yes, let's go back to Michael. He seems to be almost done.
I think I got all I need to get, so I'm ready to start cooking. Hold on. Cameramen have found Sean. We're going live now.
And it looks as though he's at a red box.
That is correct. Sean is looking at some video games, maybe? A movie?
I'm very confused. I don't know his tactic for this. It looks like he's buying a movie.
He is. He selected a film.
I don't have any ingredients yet, but I got a movie for tonight.
The contestants have finished shopping. Now we're in the kitchen, and we're gonna see how they do. I'm especially worried about Sean.
Yeah, no ingredients. I don't know how this is possible.
Alright, I got my Italian sausage cut up. I'm gonna use this as pepperoni for my pizza.
Sean, this is great. Can you tell us what exactly this is? I wanted to give you guys something great. And when I think pizza, I think pepperoni pizza with stuffed crust. That is the best pizza you could possibly have. And I really hope you guys enjoy what I got for you. I think it's going to be great.
I love the presentation here. It's an authentic cardboard box, just like you'd get in Italy. Are you kidding me? This is obviously in a Pizza Hut box. Can you not put the clues together? He didn't buy anything at the grocery store. He ordered the pizza.
Hey, Michael, can you please be quiet and let us enjoy this masterpiece? Thank you. Jeez. Wow, this is beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
That's what you want to see.
Wow. All right. Let's dig in, Ron.
Yeah. Oh, look at this. He has stuffed his crust with cheese. That is so original.
Amazing. It kind of reminds me of that Pizza Hut, like, double stuffed cheese pizza. I mean, it's just so authentic. Sean, I could keep eating this all day, and I, quite frankly, could probably eat this whole box. One of the best pizzas I've ever had.
Definitely.
I don't know what you did. I mean, at first we saw you, like, at the Red Box. I mean, what was up with that? We still have Michael's Pizza to do, but I can tell you this really set the tone for the competition.
Absolutely.
Today. Just can't get much better than this. Very well done, Sean.
I am not looking forward to eating Michael's pizza.
Yeah, I don't know how I can get much better than this. I really don't know what Michael was going for on his pizza. It kind of looked awful, if you ask me. I don't know, maybe the judges will like it, but I know my pizza was just the best. And Michael just doesn't have a chance in this competition.
All right, Michael, what have you made for us today? Today, I bring to you judges my three meat pizza. The recipe I used for this was my mother's. She's transgender and now deceased.
Aww.
Awesome. Can't wait to try it. So, Michael, I see you're going for a classic three meat pizza. I really like how you incorporated the ham, the sausage, and the pepperoni. I just wish you would have done some, like, maybe Italian sausage or something.
Yeah, some Italian sausage would have really enhanced this pizza because it's Italian. What are you talking about? I bought Italian sausage. I put it on the pizza.
Honestly, it just kind of tastes like a frozen pizza to me. It's just not original. I know you made it from scratch, but I'm just not getting what I got from Sean's pizza. It's just, it's just missing something. I just can't wrap my mind around it.
I agree. As Sean said, really not getting that homemade feel, unlike from Sean's pizza.
I know your transgender mom, she would have been proud, I guess. Michael, thank you, and I hope you do better the next round. I know you will. You're a talented chef, and we can't wait to see what you make next round.
I can't believe it. What the judges were saying about Sean's pizza versus mine, a transgender homemade recipe versus... A Pizza Hut pizza. They had the box that said Pizza Hut on it. I hope I come back stronger next round.
It was actually a very good pizza, but I just don't like the kid.
Same. This whole transgender mom story.
Yeah, it's bullcrap.
It's not what you want to see.
Nope.
Delicious pizza, though.
Very good. Very good. The judges wanted something classic, so it doesn't get much more classic than brownies. And I'm going to add my own unique flavor to it. It looks as though Sean is maybe a little lost in this section. Ron, what is he picking up?
Sean has just picked up dill weed, which I believe he's mistaking for actual weed.
Weed brownies.
Another American classic.
Nice.
Before my transgender mom passed away, she taught me this brownie recipe that I'm going to use today. And I'm hoping this is going to help me win this competition because I lost the entree round. These brownies are special because I'm going to be putting caramel inside of them. Wish me luck. Hey, welcome back. I'm Ron Burgundy. couldn't show you guys earlier when I was cooking, because it's a secret recipe, so you can't know my ratios. But what I can show you is my one-handed egg crack. Some other less talented chefs, if you can even call them that, left a bit of a mess in the kitchen.
So for today, I made you a classic American dessert, brownies. It was a double fudge brownie, and my unique ingredient, well, I'll let you guys figure it out for yourselves.
All right, thank you, Sean. Let's dig in.
Yep.
They smell a little, like my college days.
Yeah.
Let's give these a try.
All right, so Ron seems to really like these brownies. I'm gonna have to go with, you know, they were good. I will say they were good. They weren't the best brownies I've ever had. Ron, you got anything you want to add to this? All right, thank you, Sean. It was very unique, and Ron has had a lot, and we will make sure he gets home safely. All right, jeez. All right, Michael, what do you have for us today?
These brownies are a recipe from my transgender mother. Before she passed away, she taught me how to make these. I know when I'm at home and I'm having a bad day, I make these and they lift me up, and I hope they can lift you guys up.
Awesome.
I hope my doesn't fall off from this transgender recipe.
Let's go ahead and dig in, Ron. Honestly, just right away, it looks like someone making a brownie. But I'm still gonna try it. You really just made it a mess. Jesus! I've had enough.
I'll have it.
Ron, what is it with you and brownies? Jeez.
What?
Yeah, Michael, I'm just really disappointed. This dish, or whatever this is more disappointing than your mom's story, transgender mom.
I agree. How are they gonna tell me some pot brownie is better than my transgender mother's recipe? What kind of chefs are they? I mean, seriously.
Excuse me, Michael. Chef scene here.
What's going on?
You've been chopped.
What?
Yeah, we just didn't want you to come back. I think we agree that you just need to leave now.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
It has been an exciting episode of Chopped.
Sure has.
Ron, why don't you go ahead and tell him who won?
Sean Campbell.
Wow. Amazing performance. One of the best chefs we have ever had on this show.
Without a doubt.
Yeah. Sean, what are you going to do with the money? Awesome. Thank you guys so much. It has been such an honor to be on your show. With all this money, I'm probably just going to donate it to a transgender charity.
See?
Fuck! Thank you guys for watching.
He said guys because 82% of our viewers are males, so we're not assuming gender.
That's correct, Ron. Go ahead and subscribe to our channel, like it, because I know you're going to like this video. It was great.
I know. Seriously, subscribe, like, it's not going to kill you. If you want to see more stuff like this, down below, leave us a comment. Let us know what you thought. Are the transgender jokes too edgy?
I think it's fine.
I think it's fine.
Yeah. All right.
Peace out.
Yep. Peace out. Have a great day. And go watch your other videos because they're great.
Fucking great.